Good afternoon, dear students. In my last classes, we have discussed about the revision tool, okay? And especially we discussed about random function and randomized function. I hope all of you understood the random and randomized function, because in my classes also we have discussed about that function and we have done so many programming also based on that, okay? And then again in last classes we discuss about some string functions, okay? And after the class most of the students call me and they were having some doubts regarding different types of string function. Today I would like to clear those doubts again, okay? And that is why I have prepared this video lecture, okay? After this video lecture today I'm going to share another video lecture which will be based on your matrix, okay? Because in mathematics also you have completed, I think, mathematics, so it will be easy for us to do programming now, okay? So let's start with this string function. What is string function? Okay, as I have shared this notes, you can see here C++ provides the following two types of string representation. One is character string representation and another is string representation. This means that using this character string representation, so while declaring a variable, we can declare the variable by the type character. But the thing is, we have to mention the size. Why? Because a character, by now you know the difference between character and string, okay? So character means a single character, say A, B, C and all, okay? And string means combination of character, okay? So if you are going to use string by using character, then obviously we need to use array help, okay? Array means what? We have to mention the size, and this is about C type character string. Again, what about the second one? It is about string classes. That means while declaring a string variable, in spite of declaring it as character, we can give what? String classes. Like string, suppose variable s1, s2. Okay. Now, in this video, we will see how these two string function can be implemented with the help of practical use. Okay. So, like I said just now, this character string, okay, how this character string look like? You can see here, character getting, okay? This character is a character type and getting is a variable having size 3, okay? And this getting is a variable, the value of this getting will be what? H E L L O, and this is slash 0, okay? So this is what, this is the initialization, this is known as the initialization, okay? This value we are giving here by default, okay? Since H is a character, we are giving here single quotation, here also single quotation, that means this is a character, this is a character, okay? And you can see here just below the greetings, you can see here character greeting, here I am not giving any size. And the value of this greeting is what? Hello. You can see here, in hello, we are having 5 character combining. And we are giving here quotation, double quotation. That means this is a string value and these are the character value. I hope you understand. And come back to this part here. After this value, we are assigning here a slash 0. Why? Because you see, if you go through this definition, you will find that after initializing the last, suppose O is the last character of greeting, okay, to represent end of the string we used to give here what? Slash 0. And this is actually automatically, the compiler will automatically generate this slash 0. This means end of the string, okay? Now come back to our example. Okay, here you can see here in C character string, you can see here the variable here. This is the index, and as I have already mentioned, that index always starts from 0, 1, like that. And the fifth position, that means sixth position, this one, okay, 0 to 5, this is the sixth position. Here you can see here slash 0. This slash 0 is automatically initialized by the compiler. And since this is the example of what? character string. See, each character will have separate address. See, you can see here address. For each address is 0x, these are some. These strings you don't have to worry about that, because compiler will automatically generate these addresses for each of the character. Okay, now let's come back to our previous example. As you can see here, I have given one example here. Okay, so header file. Okay, inside the main we have declared character string 6. Okay, these are the value, initialize value. So see out greeting message. So this is the message going to display and the value of greeting. What are the value here? H-E-L-L-O, hello, that means. So when you run this program, your output will come greeting message colon hello. Okay, I'll show you with the help of programming also. Okay, our next programming example was this one. Okay. Okay, before I proceed with the programming example, let us see what are the string function we have discussed. Okay, the first string function is string CPY. This means what? This string function will copy the value of one variable to the another variable. And the way how this value is to copy? Okay, see, always the right side value will be copied to the left side value. Okay, and see, this is a function. Okay, and s1 and s2 here, we can say these are the two arguments. Okay, this s2 is one string argument, this s1 also one string argument. Now the s2 value will be copied to the s1 value. Okay, just remember that string copy is basically used to copy the value of one variable to the another variable. I'll show you with the help of example. Okay, our next function is about strcat. Same here also, two argument is taking s1 and s2. Okay, so what is the purpose of this function? This function will concatenate two string, or you can say this function will combine two string. Okay, how you can see here, this function, suppose say s1 is having hello and s2 is having world. So if we run this function, or if we execute this library function, our output will be hello world. Clear? Okay, now proceed to the next library function. It is about strlen. Okay, this is having a single argument s1. Why? Because the purpose of this string function, string len, strlen function, is to give the length of a string, and here the output will be in numeric value. Suppose hello, so in hello there are 5 characters. So if you represent strlen s1, and suppose s1 is having hello, then suppose here I'm writing here, suppose s1 equal to, we are having suppose here hello. So how many character here? H-E-L-L-O, 5 character. So this function will give us the value 5. Clear? Okay, next, the fourth library function, string library function, is strcmp. Okay, this function is again taking two argument, or I can say string argument. So s1 and s2. The main purpose of this strcmp library function is to compare two string. How this comparison will go on? Okay, I'll show you with the help of one example. Okay, so this comparison, suppose s1 is having hello and s2 is having world. So character wise they will check. If both the strings are exactly equal, then it will return 0. If not, okay, then if s1 and s2 are same, then it will return 0. And if s1 is less than s2, okay, then you see here less than 0 if s1 is less than s2, greater than 0, okay, if s1 is greater than s2. Okay, and the last two function, actually these two function we have not discussed in the classes, in first year classes. So here I'll show you. See this str, okay, character. This is string character. Okay, it returns a pointer to the first occurrence of the character ch in a string. Matlab a string, there will be one string. Okay, then this character value, how many times the character value occurred in that particular string, he will display that. Okay, same way str, that means what? Suppose you will, there will be a string hello good morning. Okay, so hello good morning, so a particular, there is, see, suppose I'm giving here hello good morning. Okay, so this is a string, so you can see here there are three word, hello good morning. Okay, so since this is, you can see here str, that means here this is a whole string. Out of this string, is any repeated string is there? Suppose hello is repeated here or not? No, that means this will return a pointer to the first occurrence of string 2 in string 1. Say this is s1, in this s1 is there another string s2. Okay, that means this will return the string within a string. Okay, I'll show you with the help of example. Now I hope this 6 string library function is clear to you all. If not, also now I am going to show you one show you with the help of a programming example. So as you can see here, I have already created a function. Okay, we'll start from the beginning again. Okay, so we'll close this. Okay, let's learn. We'll create a new function. Okay, so we'll start a new project here, console. Okay, as you all know in these things, how we can create a separate project in Woodblock. Okay, so string, suppose we are giving a sub project title function. Let's proceed with this function. Okay, so this is the function we have. Okay, this is the hello world program. Okay, now we are going to do the string function. Okay, let's do it. So to do string function, we have to include here a header file called has include string dot h. Okay, and this will be remain same. Okay, now we will remove this. So integer main. Okay, so as you all know that this main is a driver function. That means after executing this header file, compiler will directly access to the driver function main. Okay, here the type of this main is integer. Okay, and that is why we are returning here 0. This means that this program will successfully executed when everything will be done. Okay, now let's create the variable, string variable. Say we have a, okay, string variable character, suppose s1. So character, we are going to create here string, so we have to give the size here s1. Okay, s2, here so you give 10. Okay, now we will give some default value to s1 and s2. Okay, say if we write here s1 equal to hello. Now the question is, can we write like this, or can we assign the value hello to s1 like this? Okay, no. Why? Because this s1 is what? A character string, and the value is what? String value. Okay, so type is not matching. You can say we cannot assign like this. Suppose we have a numeric variable, say we have a numeric variable integer number, okay, equal to 10, declares at the same time. Here we cannot do this in terms of character string. Okay, because type is not matching. Okay, so for copying this, what we have to do, we have to use string copy, strcpy. Okay, so here we have to write like this. In which variable we are going to copy? In s1. What value we are copying here? Hello. See, here I have not given any quotation because this is a variable. Okay, and here I am giving double quotation because this is a value, string value. Okay, semicolon. That means now after executing these statements, the hello will be assigned to variable s1. Okay, now let's take the variable for s2. Okay, s2, same, we cannot assign like s2 equal to some values, we cannot assign. Okay, so what we have to do, again we have to take help of the string copy function, spy. Okay, so here where we are going to copy the value? In s2. What value? Say world, world. Okay, hello world. Is it clear? Okay, after executing these two statements, s1 will have value hello, s2 will have value world. Clear? Now what we'll do, we will find the length of string s1. How to do that? We'll do like this, strlen. Okay, here in which variable, for which variable we are finding the length? Say for s2. Okay, for s2. After this, suppose what you can say, okay, so this string length will give, strlen s2 will give the value, a numeric value, that means 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, but we have to keep that value somewhere. Okay, let's say we are going to declare len one variable equal to, we have to declare here again, this will hold the numeric value, so integer len. Okay, so now you display it, see out the length of of s2 equal to, what is it? It will be in len. So len. Now let's execute this function. Okay, so run it. As you can see here, the length of s2 equal to 5. You can see here, clear? So we have seen how we can use this string length. Okay, now what we'll do, we will let's comment this. Okay, we are not going to use again. Now we are going to copy, we have seen. Okay, now we are going to see how to concatenate two string. Okay, say we have to combine this. S1 is having hello and S2 is having world. So we have to combine this S1 and S2. So to combine this, can we write like this, S1 plus S2? No, we cannot write like this. We cannot add like this. Then how we are going to proceed with this? For doing that, again, we have to take help of the what? strcat, concatenated. strcat. Which variable we are going to concatenate? S1 and S2. Okay. Now, this value will be concatenated. Now, you see here, display it, see out. Let's see the output. The concatenation of S1 and S2. equal to it will be what, what you can say s1. Now s1 will have both hello and world. Okay, so let's save it and you display it. See, the concatenation of s1 and s2 equal to hello world, both the string is concatenated now. Okay, now after this, let's compare these strings. Okay, so what we can do, suppose str CMP. Okay, we are going to compare this. Okay, say S1, S2. Okay, so what will this function return? Or you can do like this. Cout the comparing S1 and S2 colon. I'm writing here. Let's display it, save it, run it. So here we are getting some error. Sorry, let's see. Okay, semicolon is missing here. Save it, run it. So you can see here, as you can see here, hello world, it was previously in giving output. Okay, after that, comparing S1 and S2 is giving what? -1. Why? Because you see here, S1 is giving -1, that means less than 0. Why? Because string 1 is less than string S2. How we can say that? Because you see here, I said, as I have already told you, that this, how this comparison is to go? Character wise, suppose H is compared with character W. So what is the equivalent value for this H? It will be something, if you see, for capital A it is 65, go on like that. So something, that means obviously you can say that H is smaller than world. Same way character wise it will say, so since we are getting in the first character itself, we are getting the smaller number, so it will give -1. Okay, so in the same way, if we compare like this, suppose S2, if we change this, and here S1, here S2. Now let's see what will be the output. Okay, so as you can see here, the concatenation of this is hello world only. Okay, and comparing S1 is equal to 1, that means greater than 0. Okay, so I hope the, with this, the example, the concept of different string function is clear to you all. After my after my class, I'll give some assignments, so you have to complete those assignments. Okay, so till now, whatever we have discussed, these all are what? Characters thing. Now if you remember that during this lecture, first lecture, I have mentioned here, you see, the there are two types of string representation. First is character string, and second is using string class. Now what this string class actually it used to do? Okay, so if we use string classes, then if we don't use this string copy, string concatenation also, the output you will get. Okay, how we'll get, let's discuss this. Okay, so this is about what we're going to discuss. Using string class. Okay, so let's comment this. So we are going to declare two variables, suppose stri, and this time we are going to use string classes. This is a class. Okay, string s1 s2. Okay, say now we can assign like this, s1 equal to hello. Okay, and s2 equal to world, hello world, give it semicolon. Okay, yes it was not possible in earlier case, but this is possible. Why? Because this time we are using a string class. Okay, so now we can declare, we can add also. Okay, suppose s1 plus s2, we can do it, and the value, suppose we are going to assign in another variable s3. Okay, so s1 s2, you have to declare s3 also here. So give it semicolon. Now you display the value of this s3. okay, the, what you can say, the concatenation of S1 and S2 will be equal to, okay, S3. Done. Let's run this program. 1 minute. Okay, semicolon, save it, run it. You see the output here. The concatenation of S1 and S2 is equal to hello world. You can see here hello world is displayed here. But in earlier case, there was what? There was some error. But here, by using string class, we can do this way also. So I hope you all understood the concept of string library function. So just remember that in string function we can use character string and we can use the string class also. When you use character string, we have to take help of the different string library functions, say character, string copy, string concatenation and all. And by using string classes, if we don't use those functions also, those library functions also, it will work. Why? Because everything is belongs to this class string. Okay, so with this I'll conclude today's classes. In the next video lecture, I'm going to discuss some of the matrix programming, because you have already completed in mathematics also. So it will be good for now to start the matrix program. Okay, thank you.